This is your second stimulus update package, your second stimulus check update. Today is Friday and nothing has happened. The Democrats and the Senate have, the House Republican Senate have met and they've come up with nothing, and it is the weekend and many members have gone on 3-day vacation. Mitch McConnell has said that the Senate will still be in session next week, but we will see. We're at a point where nothing may happen between the Senate and the Democrats. We're at DEFCON 5. There are people who are losing their $600 per month employment benefits, and there are many, many people who are on the verge of being evicted. The Democrats want to give people the full Monty. The Republicans want to put up piece by piece temporary legislation versus versus a whole and complete package. There are many, many holdups about the payroll protection, about workers' liability, and so on and so forth. Essentially, we may not have a stimulus package until September, which does bode well for Trump. And speaking of Trump, Trump is extremely frustrated, and Trump has said he will issue executive orders for unemployment, eviction, payroll taxes, and one other thing. Trump is, you know, about to push to the limit his executive powers to get some stuff done because he is frustrated. Donald Trump at this juncture wants a second stimulus package. He wants a second stimulus check. However, Money Mitch ain't having it. Money Mitch sees that Trump is weak. Money Mitch sees that Trump could be considered a lame duck president. And Money Mitch is gonna do what Money Mitch wants to do. So until Mitch McConnell actually steps up to the table and starts attending the meetings, Democratic leader Chuck Schumer said that Mitch McConnell was not even in the room during the negotiations. That should tell you a lot. That should tell you much. And also, you want to understand that most of these Congress people are millionaires. They're rich. So they're very much disconnected from the plight of the average person. And this is one of the reasons that this is taking so long, because they are so far away from the pain. They've been in office so many years that they don't really understand what the traditional run-of-the-mill American is going through. And it's about to get really, really bad. We may go through this whole thing, and by some strange check, because the Democrats want a second stimulus package and a second stimulus check, Donald Trump wants a second stimulus package and has gone on record that he wants to cut the people a check. But the Republicans and half of the Republican Senate do not want to cut a check. This is problematic for many, many reasons. And if I can go ahead and put my political calculation into the game, Trump is weak and Trump is looking at a very good chance of losing the next election. And the Senate Republicans know this, so they're not afraid of Trump like they used to be, and they may virtually stick to their guns and not vote for a second stimulus package. Now, let me go ahead and give you what I think is going to happen. I feel that they're going to work something out that will be deficient, it will not be enough, and people will get a check, and that will be a band-aid for a minute. And I feel that the people will start to vote in their own best interest, and they're going to vote Democrat this election, and the Democrats are going to get the Senate, they're going to get the presidency, and then we're going to see the mother of all stimulus programs. We're going to see the mother load of all stimulus programs, because the Democrats will be able to do whatever they want regardless of whatever the Republicans want or don't want. So fully expect the mother of all stimulus package, stimulus checks. We may potentially get $2,000 per month. I should say you, it will not be me, UBI, I feel that the first version of universal basic income will come around March of 2021, because they got to wait until the president and the Senate is sworn in January, then they got to sit down and hash it out. But I feel that this is where we're heading, because the second stimulus package, if it happens, and that's a very possible chance of it not happening, is setting the stage for the mother of all stimulus packages and stimulus checks and unemployment boost. And also, unemployment was 1.3 million people last week, and it is still way higher than it was during the last recession. And unemployment is going to remain high, and that's going to be a problem. I've been out and about. I've noticed that the economy is improving. The economy is opening up. More people are going back to work. More people are being productive. But we're still going to have this scar of the pandemic on the economy for a long, long time. So one of the things that you should think about is starting your own economic stimulus package. Because look at what happened. Right now, at the height of this thing, we had 40 million people, about 42 million people unemployed, and the Senate was sitting on their hands. The Senate actually did not do anything for those 42 million people. And I think unemployment, they say it's at 10%, but if you look at true unemployment, we still have about 25 million people unemployed, with more people going to the unemployment rolls each day. So we still have a lot of people who are unemployed. We still have many businesses that are closing, but fully expect to see some wilding out by Donald Trump the closer we get to election, because right now with the pandemic, with the election, he is in a pressure cooker situation. His stress level is DEFCON 10. And we will see Trump acting up. We will see Trump doing and saying things that will maybe borderline bizarre, because he is at wit's end with Money Mitch. Money Mitch used to be his boy. Money Mitch is no longer his boy. Money Mitch has his own agenda. And this is what's stalling all of the stimulus talks. The Democrats want to do something. The president wants to do something. But Money Mitch and those of 25 Republicans in the Senate don't want to create a second stimulus package. They don't want to do it. They're going to drag their feet and they're going to keep going on. So what should one do? Over here at Savage Finance, I have a video that is going a little crazy. It's about stop freaking out about your FICO score, and I'm having many, many people who are fighting and being resistant to the message of being self-sufficient and having cash reserves. Do you understand that if you had a year's of living expenses in your long-term savings account and $5,000 in your short-term savings account, and you had a family operating account, that this would have not been a big deal for you? You would have just had more time to be at home. You've been able to pay your bills. You wouldn't have got behind. And this is one of the cores that I keep pushing: the sound financial principles of dealing with cash. Right now, I have some financially illiterate people who are debating me about the debates of credit. But here's the thing. There are people with good credit right now who are having their credit card accounts cut off, shut down, or they're having their credit limits reduced. And these people have good credits, never missed a payment. But once again, we have a group of people who are literally addicted to credit. They're addicted to it, and they don't know how to function without it. And once they lose it or get to this hostile economic banking environment that we're about to enter, because see, the banks have already done the calculations, and they know that if times get hard, you're gonna pull out that plastic. So what they're doing, and they have predictive software, and they're looking at people, and they're looking at credit profiles, and they're looking at people that they feel will potentially overextend themselves and create financial harm for their credit card portfolio, and they're getting rid of them. American Express is cutting people left and right. Chase is cutting people. Citibank is cutting people. Capital One, I haven't heard much about them. But essentially, many of the prime banks are cutting people. So if you are dependent upon your credit as your emergency fund, you may find yourself in a position where you will not have enough credit and you will not be able to get any more credit, because once you start using your credit to an extreme level, then it makes it very hard to get more credit because that depreciates your credit score. So we have many, many people. So what I want you to do is listen to this message. What I want you to do is go below, get 30 days to 2,500. Just don't get it because it's free, but get it and do the work and create you a side hustle. Right now, there are many people that an additional $300 to $500 per month would be life-saving. It would be the difference between eating and not eating, $300 to $500. One of the things that you have to understand, because I was doing some research on secured credit cards for Savage Finance, and most of them, they start off like, hey, you can open up your account with $300. And I'm sitting there like, why are all these guys saying this? Because this is the position that so many people are in, that they cannot fund a $5,000 credit card account. They cannot fund a $10,000 credit, secure credit card account, because the banks have the data. They know that people don't have the money. And this is one of the reasons that I am being extremely obstinate about getting your financial life together, getting your savings accounts together, getting your short-term savings account together, getting your family operating together, and also increasing your income. Even if you have a job, you're going to create a side business. Yes, this is going to require you to work more hours per week, but you're going to do this to secure your future. Because the future is 2021, like 2020, the year of the murder hornet, the pandemic was rough for many people. 2021 is going to be worse. Why is it going to be worse? Many of the unemployment benefits are going to run out. That's going to create an issue. Many of people who sign up for forbearance, the clock, ding, 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 it's going to start ticking, and they're going to have to make up those payments. And I have people who's like, hey, they've amended the program that these people could shift those payments to the end of the loan. In the 2009 to 2015 recession, well, 2007 to 2015 recession, there were many people who were eligible for loan modification. Millions applied, only 3,000 to 4,000 people got the modifications. I respect to revisit that type of financial bureaucracy with these people in forbearance. And the people with equity will be able to sell their homes and escape to real estate investors such as myself, who will be like, oh, you want 250 for your home? I only got 220 cash. I can close in 10 days. What you gonna do, player? They're gonna be dealing with that. Because those of us, because recently, if you didn't know, I recently bought a Porsche. I was at the dealership and the dealership was packed. Why was the dealership packed? Porsche and other car dealers have been cutting the price of the cars. My car would have been about 105, 117-ish. I got it for $90,000. So what is happening is stuff is starting to go on sale, and next year it's going to go on fire sale. And this is going to create opportunities for those people who are properly aligned and positioned, who have cash, not credit, but cash, who can make some moves. They're going to come out of this recession much, much richer. They're going to come out of this recession wealthier, because their cash is going to go much further. Jeff Bezos just sold $3 billion worth of stock. I wonder what he's getting ready to invest in. So go ahead, take the courses, and also go below and sign up for Oxygen Bank, and we'll tell you what to do with the account. You got the hustler's mindset, you got 30 days to 2,500, and then the new money that comes in your life, because it's new money, you're not used to it. So that all of this new money is going to go into this new account. And yes, if you sign that link below, it is a referral link. I get $25, you get $25. Once you fund the account for $200 and use the debit card 5 times in 60 days. And this is how we do this thing, because we're making money together, we're getting better together. And I think it's a crazy opportunity, because I've had some communications with Oxygen Bank and they're being bombarded. They haven't prepared for the onslaught. So if you're trying to open up your business account, you're looking at 3 to 4 weeks, because that's how backed up they are. So the personal account is going to act as your business account, and then this will act as your way for you to get credit extension from Oxygen Bank to you, and then later you can go ahead and, well, you can go ahead and put in your app. I put in my app about going on 2 weeks ago, so I should be getting approved in the next 2 weeks for my business account, and I will do a review on that and let you guys know how that is happening. Also, be sure to subscribe to Savage Finance. I've got a lot of hot stuff that's coming, a lot of wonderful topics, and I am going to start the Money Show next week. And what is the Money Show? We're going to be talking about credit investing. We're going to be talking about real numbers, real things, and people will get to call in and ask questions. So that's going to be the Money Show. It's probably going to happen once or twice a week. It's not going to be every day like, you know, I was doing here, but I feel that it will be beneficial and it will help you out. And I feel it's going to be a lot of fun because I've already set up the studio and I'm just waiting to go ahead and launch the first episode. So that's all I got for you guys today. Go below, get 30 days to 2,500. Go below, get the hustler's mindset, prepare your mind for success. Go below and sign up for Oxygen Bank and go ahead and get your free account, because someone had put a thing in there like to actually deposit a check and cash a check immediately. They're gonna hit you over the head for $50, or you can just wait 6 to 7 days. I chose to wait 6 to 7 days because I wasn't gonna spend $50 to cash a check. So if you choose to use those expenses options, that's on you. This is your second stimulus package update, your second stimulus check update, Friday, August 7th. Hope you are well, and be sure to watch the next video.